Merchant.
Andrew Bailey.
Thank you. Thank you, Madam Chair. I'm very appreciative. Hey, well, guess what? The unions are back in charge, aren't they? They're back in charge. You know, I find it fascinating, the very first piece of language used reporting about this bill, our suite of changes to promote and strengthen collective bargaining and union rights in the workplace. Beautiful. Beautiful. And even Labor went on to say and admit this law is about strengthening union rights and union members. Well, isn't 2020 going to be fun? When we got a Labor New Zealand First government standing up there, now I can see the Honourable Shane Jones on the other side, standing up on the hustings, talking about what a great this thing this is for New Zealand, how we are driving forward New Zealand, making it more prosperous by bringing about this change. Well, I think that's going to be a really interesting argument, because this is a continuing process by this Labor New Zealand First government to remove the lid of optimism from business. The lid of optimism. And, you know, we've seen it, they're imposing the costs on businesses. They're right, they can pay for it, they're good at for it. Second thing, making it harder for immigrants to come into New Zealand and work in our good businesses in New Zealand. And now we've got these wide-ranging employment changes. And that's all going to be that framework that cuts to the core of how we operate in New Zealand. And I just think there's an assumption around this, and that is, the first thing I want to say is I support the role of unions. They have a part to play, albeit it's interesting in the market environment they've had to play. They've seen their union membership plummet because people didn't see the need to join a union. There are only 355,000 people in the union movement out of 2.7 million in New Zealand. That tells you what they see the value of the union movement. But there are cases where we do not have good employers. But the corollary is also, not all employers are bad employers. And the vast majority of the 530,000 businesses we've got in New Zealand, they are good. They're family-run businesses, hard-working mums and dads, working there, employing their people, good people. They're part of the fabric of those businesses, and in most cases, they are doing a great job, and there's a teamwork, and that's how everyone survives, including political parties. And that's why teamwork, and that's why the assumption that we need to make these wholesale changes, I do not believe the case has been made. And I want to talk about the issue around the Mecca. We've heard a bit about this, but one aspect that we've heard a little bit, and my colleague Andrew talked about it from down in Timaru, and he used the example of transport from Timaru to Takapuna. And that is right. In many businesses, people choose to work the way they want to work. I know in my wife's business, where most of them are women who want to go to work early, often don't want to take long lunch breaks because they want to get home to their children. And they have got the flexibility around that. So the worst thing about the Mecca Award, is how it can be imposed. And we know how the union's going to go about doing it. They will find those businesses that are the wealthy ones who can make the changes, or the ones that are in a position where they have to agree to union demands. They will deride those changes, and then they will spread them across the rest of the industry and standardise the employment arrangements. And I don't think that's right. I don't think that's right. People should have the right to work out when they want to work, how they want to work, and on what basis they want to work. The other thing that hasn't been picked up on is that under Clause 12, the unions have the right to actually initiate bargaining 20 days earlier than employers. And I don't understand this, and I'd really like if the Minister could deal with this. There's been absolutely no explanation from the government why union representatives should be able to begin bargaining earlier than the employer, 20 days earlier in both cases. And I refer to 12, 4...
Madam Chair.
I call the Honourable Ian Lees-Galloway.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I want to briefly speak...